Hey, what's up? This is just going to be a quick tip on how to create text in geometry nodes. And the reason I wanted to share this is that I was playing with this and I noticed that with geometry nodes, you have way more flexibility on how to control the topology of your text mesh that you end up with. And you can make it look way nicer than the regular Blender text. So let me show you what I mean with the regular Blender text. We just add a regular text object and we create some wonderful text. And there we are. I actually want to change the font because I have seen this font too many times. And I'm just getting a bit. All right, let me just use this one. All right, so here we have some text. It looks good, but if we turn on our wireframe, we can see the topology of this of these letters is actually really messed up, and it doesn't look good at all. And the only control we have about this topology is the resolution, and we can make it lower resolution, higher resolution. I guess the one thing that it is good at is it's quite efficient with how many points it uses. So when there's a curved there's a curved line, it uses a lot of points to make it look smooth. But when there's a straight line, it only uses the minimum amount of points. So in that regard, it's quite nice and efficient. But I just, this doesn't look good at all. So let's go to geometry nodes and try to make this, try to improve on this. For geometry nodes, we need an object. So I'm gonna just add a mesh. I'm gonna delete everything and I'm gonna call this GeoNodes text. And we have nothing. Let's create a new geometry node tree. We don't need the input because there's nothing. And we're gonna add text. It's under text. And we're gonna do string to curves because we're gonna immediately create curves out of this. So let's plug that in. And let me organize this a little bit. Okay, let's create the same string here and use the same font as well. And now if we move this thing out of the way, we can see we have the same text. But our geometry nodes text is only curves and it's not filled in at all. One easy way to do that is to search for fill curve. We plug that in and there we go. We now have the same, exactly the same shapes. This is the geometry node text and this is the regular text. If we turn on our wireframe here as well, then you can see it's also the same kind of topology, sort of. It's almost the same. The density is the same. So how can we control this better with geometry nodes? So what this fill curve does is it goes from a curve and it creates a mesh out of this. One thing we can already do is create n-gons instead of triangles, which is pretty nice. And depending on what you want to do with this text, this could be very cool. But if you want to do some, like I was doing this in the context of 3D printing, so I kind of want to end up with triangles. So I'm gonna keep this at triangles, and I want to still have a nicer topology here, even though I use triangles. So let's look at how we can do this. A nice way to control how many points are on your curve, how many points are used with these triangles, is to resample your curve. You can search for resample and take the resample curve node. And this makes it look like a child wrote this with crayon. But we have some control here. So if we change this main thing to evaluated, we go back to the normal way that it looked. It's actually no different. If we mute this, it's exactly the same. But the nice one I like is length, where you can set a constant length and it will just start at the beginning of the curve. It's a circular curve, so it's like, I don't know, I'm not sure where the beginning is, but it takes a point on the curve and then it goes this length along the curve and it goes to the next, it creates a next point. Then it goes again that length and it takes a constant number, a constant length, and this makes our topology way more consistent. And we can still use n-gons if we want with this, but to make this text look a little bit nicer it's just a matter of lowering this number, this length, and you can increase the number of points that you get on your letters. And that's pretty good. We can go a little bit higher probably. And it's depending on what you want to do. If this text is far away in the background, you don't need much resolution here. And we can turn off wireframe, and still it looks really nice. So that's a way to control your topology better. Now, what if you want to make this text 3D? Because now it's just flat 2D planes, pretty much. With the regular text, it's very, very easy. You just go to geometry and you extrude this a little bit, and you have 3D text. But still, it's like very nasty topology. In geometry notes, you can also extrude, and that's why I'm on Blender 3.1, because 3.0 doesn't have this node yet, but 3.1 does. So after our fill curve, after we have gone to a mesh, we can search for extrude mesh. And there we go. That's how you create the 3D shape that you want. You want to maybe lower this a little bit. And the only difference between the text object is it extrudes in both directions. This one just extrudes in one direction, but you can easily figure that out with other geometry nodes. And there we go. The only thing that you want to be aware of is it doesn't leave the back faces, and it creates all these internal faces that you don't want. If you want to remove those internal faces, you can uncheck individual, and then it takes all the connected faces as one and it extrudes that. And if you want to also have the back faces here, you can join these two nodes and use a join geometry, and that will add the back face. The only problem now is that the back face was facing up, and it is still facing up because it's the same exact thing. So you can check that using the face orientation. And as you can see, the regular text is all blue and nice because it's all facing outward. If the face is facing the, if you're looking at the back of the face, you see the red color. So that's what's happening here. If we before we were extruding this was the outside and this was the inside of the faces, and that did not change by extruding and joining. So the only thing we have to do to make this proper, well, actually two things. One thing is to flip this face around, and there's simply a flip faces node for that, so we can do that. Now it is facing the proper direction. And then the final thing we need to do to make this a proper mesh is to merge by distance, which merges the vertices and the edges that were here, because we had this part and we had this part and we just add them together. But by merging, you can see, if you look at the number of, if we turn instances, if we realize the instances and we make actual meshes out of this, you can see how many vertices, edges, and faces we have. Before we have 2.7k vertices. If we merge, we still have 2.7 because it's rounding. Let me increase this to prove a point. I hope this is okay. You cannot see that. There we go. Merge by distance only works after you realize the instances. So realizing instances, like before, it's hard to explain, but before we did that, we had 18 instances, and it's just kind of like, yeah, it's nothing, it's not a mesh just yet. But when we actually realize the instances, we can do more granular stuff with it. So when we realize them, we have vertices, edges, faces, and we have 1,100 vertices before merging. After merging, we go down to 730, so it removes all these duplicate vertices that are here. And the thing you want to be aware of is that you have this distance set lower than this length, because if you set this to 0.1, it's going to remove, it's going to take the distance along the curve is going to be smaller than the distance that it should merge. So then you end up with this crayon style text again, which is not good. So let's set it back. And now we can lower this length to something more high resolution. And there we have it. We have our nice consistent 3D text. And if we use n-gons, it looks even nicer with this, the sides very consistent and the top very clean. So that's it, how to create 3D texts with better control in geometry nodes. And this is our final node tree. I found this really nice arrange node plugin. It's standard in Blender, and it can really clean up your node tree quite a bit. Let me put this at 40. And this is our final node tree. Hope that helps. And see you in the next one. Bye-bye.